Today, you both begin your journey as husband and wife, which is sometimes referred to as the longest ride. Remember that love is imperfect. It isn't a fairy tale or a storybook. Love is overcoming obstacles, facing challenges, holding on, and never letting go. Love is beautiful, and love is what makes the ride worthwhile.
First, Liz, I just want to say I love you. I'm blessed to be here with you, surrounded by family and friends that love us, and to have God as a witness. I promise to keep God foremost in us and our family. I vow to pour myself out for you as Christ did for the church, and I vow to love you unconditionally, no matter the season. I promise to hold fast to you and put our bond first, to hold tight to our memories and our plans, to cherish your laughs and your smiles.
From the moment you let me sit in the shade while you sat in the hot sun with your tucked in long sleeve button up on our first date, I knew you were special. When I look back on our relationship, God has shown me how His timing is perfect in every way. From how we met to when we got engaged and now today as we vowed to be husband and wife. One of my favorite aspects of God is how eventually He allows us to see the whole picture. Today you are my whole picture.
Above all else, I vow to love you till Christ calls us home. Elizabeth, with God as a witness, as we enter into this lifelong commitment to one another, I have one final vow for both of us. May we hold each other accountable to these vows, to be nourishing to one another, sharpening each other's faith, and bring joy to one another. I love you.
Every hardship, misstep, and joy has led us to this moment because we put our trust in the Lord. I have prayed for you and I have prayed for us. Cool, you are my best friend, the person I can be most open and vulnerable with. You are my safe place. I love that you know every word to most Irish song and whistle when you come in the house to let me know you're there. You are thoughtful and patient with me. You encourage me in my passions and remind me that the most important thing in life is our relationship with Jesus. Cole, I vow to love and respect you. I vow to support and encourage you through all that life brings. I vow to be your partner and friend. I vow to always make Jesus the center of our lives and to raise our kids to love and serve the Lord. You are mine and I am yours today and all. I love you.
During every season of life, the two of you will be able to set an example for others in hope. Because even when you find yourself in a less than ideal season, and you will find yourself in a less than ideal season at times, you will have the ideal Savior to walk with you every step of the way. Because the fact of the matter is that adversity doesn't stand a chance when God is for you. Darkness doesn't stand a chance when the light of the world is at the center of yours. And nothing will be able to overcome you because you are overcomers in Him. Guys, I promise you that Jesus really is that good. He is the hope for your future and the hope for your marriage, even through your most difficult days. And the Bible has good news for us. It says that hope never puts us to shame. But as believers in Christ, we recognize that we were never made to live selfishly. We were made to live selflessly. We were made to love. In a relationship has never been about what you can get from something. It's always been about what you can give to that relationship. It's always been about the honor that you can show. But the forgiveness that you can extend to one another, the mercy that you can show, the sacrifice that you make on behalf of one another. Guys, all of that adds up to love. Now, Jesus, of course, He's the greatest example of love in all of human history. He was the creator and king of the universe, and yet He came not as a man to be served, but to serve and to give His life for each and every one of us. As a minister of the Lord Jesus Christ and before Almighty God, I now pronounce you husband and wife. You are no longer two, but one. What God has brought together, let no man separate. Cole, you may now kiss your bride. Now give to you for the very first time, Cole.
to another day. Where we going, I don't know, but I'm on the way. Yeah, gotta keep it on a high note. Give it everything you got, baby, where to go? My God, good vibes, I need it, feeling so fly. Cloud nine on my feet and at the same time. It's going down, I can see, now it's time. And I'm right where I wanna be, yeah. It ain't a cloud in the sky, feel good to be alive, yeah. All I gotta say is all good.
Because it's not based just in yourself, just in your own emotions, just in your feelings and expressions of love. And those will come and go and fade and change. But Christ Jesus is the same today, yesterday, today, and tomorrow. So with that, Elizabeth, you're in good hands because you're in Christ's hands. Cole is a minister of Christ to you. Cole, you're in wonderful hands because Elizabeth is a minister of Christ to you.
We had this rock wall in the front yard, and I knew Cole was the right guy when he was picking up these massive boulders like ping pong balls. And I thought to myself, this is the exact guy the boys and I need. So I knew Elizabeth was serious. A couple weeks later, she asked me what I thought of Cole. And what she didn't realize was that the boys and I had already made up our mind. He was perfect. To Elizabeth and Cole, may your lives be blessed with love, laughter, and adventure. May you continue to grow together, supporting and encouraging each other along the way. May you build a home filled with love, warmth, and tranquility. And may your love shine and be an inspiration to all.
I'll be right back.